Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. In this video, I want to talk to you a little bit about consistency. I'm calling this video Consistency Killed the Fibroid because I think that is absolutely what kills the fibroids or whatever reproductive issue you find yourself dealing with. The problem that people have when they are trying to heal from reproductive issues is that they won't stay consistent. And the reason that I know all about this is because I have had large periods of time in my healing journey over the years where it was very difficult for me to be consistent because of a lot of different reasons. And some of those reasons were reasons that, you know, really don't make any sense as to why I used them as reasons. And primarily one was food addiction. I was addicted to food, so I would do well for a little while, but then I would go back and forth. And of course, when you're going back and forth, you're not making any progress. So I had that problem. The second problem I had was caring about what other people thought about what I was doing. And for whatever reason, I was caring about whether somebody was going to say something about the whatever food I was eating, or why I was turning down something that they were offering me, or why I didn't want to eat a specific thing at a restaurant, or like the list goes on and on for the social situations. And I had to come to a conclusion where I had to stop caring about what people thought. People weren't caring so much about what I was doing to myself. When I was very sick, they had no concern about all the trips to McDonald's or whatever I chose to eat. They just kind of said, okay, that's normal. But as soon as I started eating a salad and drinking some juice and eating fruit and all those things, that's when people started having a problem with it. So I had to stop caring. And then going back to the first thing that I said, which was food addiction, I had to deal with the food addiction and put parameters in place so that I wasn't running to food all the time when I had an emotion or something came up, or whether I was happy or sad. You know, food wasn't, it's not for celebrating, it's for nourishment. That's what food is for. And so I had to learn that, because in my life, I grew up actually believing that food was just food. I didn't even recognize that it was really for nourishment. I just thought I was hungry, so I had to eat, but I didn't put the connection together. And maybe some of you can relate to that. I don't know. But I had to get to a point where I had to start being consistent with this journey. Like, I had to lay out what I was going to do, focus on that thing that I was going to do, not be looking over here, over there, up there, looking at this YouTube, looking at that YouTube, this Facebook, this Instagram, whatever it was at that time. I had to stop like looking at whatever everybody else was doing, and I had to focus in on one thing, and that was the instructions that God gave me to do in order to heal this problem. And when I got focused, that's when I started making progress. And what I see a lot of you do is you're looking at my stuff, you're looking at this stuff, you're looking at that stuff, you're looking at this stuff, that stuff, all over the place. And you never get a plan that you just stick to for a long period of time, focused, consistent effort, where you're not one foot in and one foot out, where you can allow yourself to gain progress. And so then you get frustrated and you're like, this natural stuff doesn't work. And then you're going to the hospital and getting a hysterectomy or a myomectomy or whatever you're getting, because you won't commit to just one thing and sticking it out for any period of time. And also the other thing that I see is that you give it 3 months and you're like, oh, the fibroids are still there, and so this must not be working. Or you give it 6 months and the fibroids are still there, and this must not be working. Or a year and it this must not be working. When all actuality, did you really do everything that you needed to do? Do you even know what you're supposed to do to help you to heal fibroids? That's the thing that's in my head. What I find is most people do not have a clue what they're doing. They're out there taking all this advice from everybody and piecing it together, and then they've got one foot in. Sometimes they're at McDonald's and sometimes they're not. Sometimes they're eating sugar, sometimes they're not, and they expect to see all these results, and it doesn't work that way. So it's about getting a plan and being consistent on that plan, whatever that plan. And this is not all about eating. It's about what you're putting in your body, what you're putting in your mind, how are your emotions going on, what you're putting on your body, what are you drinking, those types of things. That's what this is about. It's not about just what are you eating. You have to have the whole package put together. You have to deal with your traumas, all that stuff, and kind of go from there. And if you do that consistently, that's when you will get the results. Excuse me. That's when you'll get the results that you're looking for. So consistency killed the fibroid. That's what I'm calling this video. Consistency killed the fibroid. Consistency killed the infertility. Consistency killed the PCOS. Consistency killed the endometriosis. Whatever you want to call it, you have to be consistent. It's not going to happen unless you be consistent. And I'm not talking about perfection either. Like, let me give you an example of perfection versus one foot out, one foot in. Perfection is, you know, you have been doing what you need to do. You've been following the plan consistently. You've been being really, really great at it. Like, you've been, you know, going like a well-oiled machine down this healing road. And in one day, you have to eat at a restaurant and there happens to be some oil in the dressing that you ate. That's not an issue. Like, just your next meal, just clean it up, you know? So that's what I mean when I say consistency, when I say perfect, it's not about being perfect. So, like, don't beat yourself up because that salad you ate wasn't completely compliant because the oil had some oil in it. The dressing had some oil in it one day. But here's what I mean when I say one foot in, one foot out. You're eating great every day. You're following the plan. You know exactly how to eat because you've been in my 90-day program and you have actually learned the process of how to eat. Or you were in my fibroid detox workshop, in which, if you're interested in that, there is a link down in the description box below for the replay if you're interested in learning more about that. But if you're, you know, you're eating well all day and then all of a sudden you're like, forget it, I'm just going to Wendy's or I'm just going to have pizza. That's the one foot in, one foot out. Like, you can't do that, like, on a regular basis. Like, you start off on Monday and 5 days in, you're doing great. And then on Saturday and Sunday, you just kind of go off the rails. And then you start again on Monday, you eat well all week. And then Friday and Saturday, you go off the rails. And maybe Monday through Friday, you've been great. And then your friends call you to dinner on Friday night and they want to go get drinks. And so you go get drinks. Do you know what I mean? That's the one foot in and one foot out philosophy. So consistency is that you're doing everything that you know to do for your healing journey for the time that it's allotted. Like, in the whole scheme of things of your life, it's nothing. It's like a drop in the bucket. Like, most of you have been dealing with fibroids for 10, 15, 20 years. Some of you just got diagnosed in. You had them for a long time. You just didn't know you did. And so if you expect everything to just go away just like that, you got to put some time into this. It's not an overnight process. It might be for some person, it might be 6 months. I have had clients like that, 6 months. Some clients a year. some clients 2 years, some clients 10 years. It may take them because of all the trauma that they've got that got them in the situation in the first place, or the fact that they just never committed to the process. So they're in and out, in and out, in and out, in and out. So it prolongs the time. So what's it going to be for you? Are you going to be consistent? Are you going to be consistent? I hope so. All right. Lots of love to you. I hope you enjoyed this video. Take care.